this is Tavy
and Danny.
Yeah.
With Faster Pussycat.
Fuck
doing up. Something with Mega Metal.
I just woke up. Mega Metal rocks.
So you guys are back out on the road once again. Some definitely some road dogs, man. You guys are tearing it up all the time.
There's someone famous. That's last. You know, on the road. That's what we look for.
Now, is there any particular part of the U.S. you look forward to going out when you guys hit the road?
Wichita, Kansas. Nice. Is that pandering? No, we do have a great time every time we're here.
Mm-hmm. I mean, we're supposed to have a day off today, but we were checking out where we're going in between. We're like, Wichita's in between. So we're going to Dallas tomorrow. It's like, call Rick. It's 2K. Fuck Dave's off.
Nice. So. You guys always bring out the crowd when you guys come to town. Everyone enjoys coming out and checking out Faster Pussycat.
Yeah.
You guys have quite the fan following here in the Wichita area. Let's talk a little bit about who you got on the road with you. Do you have anybody new since the last time you guys came through?
I don't think so. Did you come with us last time?
Yeah.
Last year?
Yeah.
No.
No.
Liz, our merch girl.
And Bobby, our gopher.
I was waiting to hear what his job description was.
He's our tech. Ish. Ish.
Now, has there been...
He's our nail tech. He's our nails.
Guys, yeah, I need to get mine done. I might hit him up.
He's been doing a shitty job, so...
Yeah. So we'll keep him.
Whip him into shape a little bit.
Yeah. Torture him. Use him for...
We made him ride the bottom of the bus today. Making that up.
Use him for bait.
You put him in the bottom of the bus today. It's 150 degrees out there.
Yeah, we got something squeaky on the bus. We figure out what the hell it is. Like, get in there, find out. Yeah. Put him in there with a flashlight.
Did he find it?
I don't know.
No.
He's still in there.
Oh, man, nice.
We'll ask him tomorrow.
Yeah, just ask him. Knock a few times.
You still down there? Yep.
Breathing?
Let's talk about your guys' live show. What can the fans expect tonight from Faster Pussycat?
Just a bunch of crap. No, just kidding.
Actually, we're mixing it up for the first time in a long time, doing some new, older songs. Just different songs.
We're mixing up, playing a few different songs we haven't played in a while. A couple songs we haven't played ever.
So. Wow, that's cool.
So.
That's cool. On the subject of maybe new stuff, what's in the works for Fast Pussycat? New record that you guys working on?
Yeah, we've been working on stuff since the Donkey Show, but like you said, we keep going out on the road, so we're like, start working on this stuff, and then we like, forget about it, and come back, oh, I forgot about that song, so that's a good trap, so. Mm-hmm. We're going to try to get something out before the new year, so.
Nice.
So next summer, or something, yeah. Because we start going back out again in February.
Wow.
Come back home off of this and go to South America and then Europe and then try to get it finished up. There's a bunch of songs that are, you know, probably about 20 songs that are there, but about 5 that are almost done. So there's like still a lot of work to do. Like mostly, you know, white nerds and stuff like that. We've got a lot of cool riffs and shit that we put together.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
And in February, we're going to the Bahamas for the show.
Doing that Monsters Rock cruise.
So yeah. We're all getting leather shorts.
I already have my leather shorts. Now I finally have a place to break them out. So.
Nice. Yeah, I was getting ready to ask you about that. How did that whole thing come about? Did they approach you guys?
Fred's my old roommate, Cinderella, and Larry, the manager, Cinderella's managers. They're not one putting on the thing, Cinderella's.
And so. I know a lot of seamen.
See, it's not all the seamen. It's a cruise ship joke. That one?
Nice. So, would you say that's probably like one of the oddest venues you guys have played?
We played some weird shit before.
So, what? Never done it yet, so obviously it's a long time away.
Yeah.
Oh, shit can happen now and then.
Well, the other day, our boat almost turned into a ship. We were almost floating away. Yeah,
our bus turned into a boat.
Man, we got stuck in a flood, and the water was coming up.
That storm that just came roll through here.
Yeah.
It's like yesterday,
Two days ago.
We were in Sioux City, right where it's whole parking lot turned into 2.5 feet of water. It was coming up to the bus and up to the right up to the step.
And we were like, is it going to stop?
We couldn't get it. We're just kicking back. We had dinner. We're just kicking back, watching TV. And this thing was coming down. I got up, was stretching, but I look out the window. And it's like,
all the cars are underwater.
All of the whole parking lot was the same.
Wow, that's crazy.
That was nuts. And it was just pouring off the buildings, too, because it was kind of like in the alley parking lot. Mm-hmm. It was just like, just coming out the drains, just like gushing.
Like fire hose.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. It was like, and then all of a sudden the drain opened up, because all of a sudden you see a whirlpool like running in the parking lot. I was like, damn.
Wow. Something you wouldn't expect to see on the road.
No, especially in California.
Yeah.
Stuff
like
that.
Yeah. Well, I was born and raised in Long Beach.
Rain freaks you out, too.
Oh, yeah. I don't mind the road. I grew up in Seattle, but not like this. It doesn't happen like this up there. It's mostly just cloudy in Seattle. So. In the winter and stuff, it's gloomy. It rains more down here and stuff than it was up there.
Oh, yeah.
Get all the cold storms coming in.
Something else I want to do talk to you about is if I did some of my research right, you're doing like a line of like saddlebags.
Yeah, not saddlebags, motorcycle bags.
Yeah.
Yeah, like solo bags. Yeah, I just started it. So it's just like when I get started, I'm on the road, so okay, can't do anything while I'm out. I've even brought some tools out to fix my stuff, like my pants and stuff, but it's still like, it's just impossible to do anything when I'm like rock and roll, too. You're out here to rock.
Yeah.
So it's like, but it's fun. I like it. It's like a good little thing to do without getting in trouble and stuff. And I got my friends open up a new store in LA, too. We're putting some stuff in there, but it's all like it's all hand done, it's all custom.
Right.
Shit too. It's all
so not if you bought two, neither one of them is going to be identical.
Not really, unless you wanted one that was in particular. You know what I mean? But the latches I use, I find like old school latches. They're like off. I use stuff off of. I got some that are old World War II German pilot parachute latches and some old British aircraft safety seat latches and stuff.
Getting real creative.
They look cool. I'm just saying they look cool. They look unique. They don't look like
the same old
generic shit. Yeah.
Nice. And how did that whole idea come about?
Because I couldn't find anything I liked. I wanted to get some stuff for my bike and I was like, this looks stupid. Do something. I used to do a little bit of leather shit back in the day, so I was like, I can make something, so I did, and I was like, that actually turned out cool, and a friend of mine wanted one, so exactly, so I was like, it's a cool way to just get creative and crafty at home, and just chilling, and do something cool, that other people can enjoy too,
And now I have the coolest guitar strap in the world.
I made my bass strap for the third
time. I love it.
The mounted Budweiser bottle opener on it.
And lighter holders and a leather bag that holds a backup.
Nice.
It's
functional. Talk a little bit about, I'm just kind of going to go a little old school with you. Over the last few years, I've noticed just kind of randomly, just in some of the most obscure places, is like cat house shirts showing up. What's your take on that? How that's kind of having a resurgence for memorabilia wise?
Well, it's cool. It's like it was fun times. Me and Ricky talk all the time. So we might even do something. Get a club. I don't know if it's going to be a cat house or something completely new, but. But it's cool. I mean, that's the old days. It's like, we did it. So it's just cool to see some of that stuff. I mean, it's like 25 years later.
Did you ever think that you would see, a cat house t-shirt 25 years down the line?
Yeah, I did, actually, because I got like three of them stashed in my for my mom's. I know I have to go through that shit one of these days. So it's like, people keep pulling them out, though, too. Mm-hmm. It'll overgo, so I'm going to break it out. But, it'll be the old one, too, the first one. So.
You should write a song called Cat House.
No, I'm singing about that.
Nice.
We got that Whore House song.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's what it was originally called. It's me and Ricky started the Cat House. I would call it the Cat House.
But if you called the club...
Ricky, like, just, please...
If you called the club...
Please call the Cat House.
The Whore House, you got a different clientele.
Nice.
But that was, we demoed three songs when we first, started the band. And that was one of them.
Over the last couple of years, there's all these like social networks and Facebooks and stuff like that. How do you think that's affected Faster Pussycat? Has it helped you guys gain more fans? Has it
helped? Yeah, it helped. I mean, there's no way it could hurt. It's always helped. It's like my MySpace is like out of control. I can't even go on anymore because it's like I go on their own Faster page to post the dates and stuff, but it's just like it's just bombarded with fans and spam, so it's like whatever. So then now when I went to Facebook, and that's kind of turned into the same thing. But we get, you know, post up stuff, let people know where we're playing, if there's something new going on. And that was cool to like connect with people. Like, you can't really always answer to all of them because you get so much, you know, when you're in a band and stuff, you get a lot of just fans writing stuff too. But especially when you're on the road, you can't like, you can't even keep up with all the mail, so you don't know what's. What's up? But
do you ever randomly just like pick one or two people and just send them an email?
Oh, I do, yeah. As soon as, yeah.
Gonna
all the time.
Blow them away. It's like, oh my God, Jamie actually responded.
Yeah.
I have a question for Jamie. What's Facebook? We'll move on.
It's Bookface.
Bookface, okay.
Fuckface.
Pigface.
Nice. So how much longer do you guys have on this leg of the tour?
We're out till the end of July. Then I get a ride to Sturgis. I'm going with Gilby and Ricky and a bunch of other fun folks.
Nice. Sturgis is always a fun time.
I've never been. Last year I was supposed to go for the first time. Our tour got moved from June, July to July, August. We were in Montreal and they called me, hey, we just got here. Then we rode through. Then we did another leg of tour last year from like just before Halloween to Thanksgiving. And it's like we were coming through from Seattle to Minneapolis and stopped at Sturgis. It flew away like the second or third of November.
Yeah. Not as much going on there.
Ghost town. I'm like, where is everybody?
Yeah. There's tumbleweed.
Yeah. I took pictures and sent them to Ricky. I'm here.
Nice.
There's all the people.
So is that something you're looking forward to? Is this
riding
out there?
I just love riding my bike. Yeah.
What kind of bike do you have?
I have a 03 Night Train Harley.
Nice.
It's fun.
Nice. Do you remember what kind of, let's get a little history about your bikes. Do you remember what the first one was you ever bought?
My first motorcycle?
Yeah, your first motorcycle.
It was a Yamaha 70 Enduro. I was like 6'8", 7". I had a mini bike. I had a Hyatt that was given to me. First one I bought, like mowing logs and shit. It was like a little Yamaha Enduro, 60 or 70, I can't remember. It was like silver, purple.
So what you said what you pushed him over the line, though, was a couple of years ago, he bought a little mini bike on the road.
No, a bus driver. Bones did.
Hey, he'd drive around the parking lot all day.
Going, I was like, God, these motorcycles.
I could go bigger. Seriously, that's a true story.
It was fun.
It was green sparkle.
Nice.
Little Harley looking mini bike. Our Bones, our bus driver from that tour. Actually, our Bones' uncle's our bus driver for this tour.
Wow.
But he bought, we had a trailer too, so it's like, okay. Just rolled it up in the trailer.
We need that.
Yeah, I'm playing like Iowa, like cornfield and shit like that too. Like some parks and fair and shit. So out the mini bike rolling through town and out down gravel roads.
Go buy cigarettes.
It was so much fun. I was like, oh, I'm missing my motorcycles. That's
like that was a sweet ride though.
Cool. Well, man, I think that, you know, covered just about everything.
Cool.
Definitely. We appreciate you taking the time to chat with us for a few minutes.
Oh, no problem.
Yeah. Thanks, Mega Metal.
We're always diehard supporters.
Mega Metal!
Diehard Faster Pussycat fans.
Cool. So,
thanks a lot, man.
Much appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, thank you, guys.
Can you grab a couple pictures with you real quick?
Sure.